We are all aware of world's most expensive space telescope ever built in the history of human being. The telescope I am talking about, James Webb Space Telescope. We are all aware of James Webb's journey to its destination, which is Lagrange Point 2. After reaching its destination, James Webb went through mirror alignment and calibrations of his scientific instruments. Currently, it is just a week away from its full operations. Although it is not working on its 100% capacity, but it has started working on a super Earth lava planet 55, Cancri E. So, in this topic, we will give you some information about the super lava world and why we are saying this super Earth, although you can see in the picture that it doesn't look like our own Earth. The planet is also called the epitome of hell on Earth. Well, it is absolutely true, as it appears to be a red hot ball of lava and fire. With the help of James Webb, NASA have actually came up with two exoplanets. One is lava ball 55 Cancri E and another is slightly cooler, LHS3844b. But today our main focus would be on 55 Cancri E only. Later in the another topic, we would have the discussion on LHS3844b. NASA has already released their press statement about 55 Cancri E, and that is, an I quote, "Imagine if Earth were much closer to Sun, so close that an entire year lasts only a few hours, so close that the gravity has locked one hemisphere in permanent shearing daylight and the other in endless darkness, so close that the ocean boils away, rocks begin to melt, and cloud rain lava." Now, I would like to give you some important facts about this Earth or Super Earth. It might help you in the UPSC exam or any other PSC exam or any other government exam. Now, discovery about this planet. Because this is not the first time we are seeing this super Earth. This planet was discovered on 38 August 2004. 55 Cancri E was discovered by detecting variation in its star radial velocity. This was the process with which the planet was discovered, because there was no Kepler space telescope during those days. When the Kepler came into existence in 2010, then the things changed radically, because Nalling interferometry changed the technique of exoplanet hunting. After 2004, then in the 2010, a thing was discovered about the planet, was that the planet had been thought to be taken 2.8 days only to orbit the star. After 2010, another revelations about the planet was that the 55 Cancri E could be a carbon planet or a diamond planet. The whole planet is made up of diamond. On the December 2015, International Astronomical Union chose the name of the planet on the basis of public opinion, that was Janssen. 55 Cancri E, 40 light years away from Earth. That means, if we will be able to achieve only 1% of the speed of light, then it would take us 4,100 years to reach the carbon giant. This 1% speed is equivalent to the 3,000 times of the speed of the fastest bullet on Earth. So, from this heavier explanation, reaching 55 Cancri E is almost impossible with the help of today's technology. 55 Cancri E is also revolving around the binary star. Binary star means you will going to find two stars revolving around each other with their planets. Two stars would be balancing each other with the help of their respective gravity. Our planet 55 Cancri E is also revolving around 55 Cancri A, not 55 Cancri B. 55 Cancri A is a yellow dwarf star similar to our own sun, but 55 Cancri B is a red dwarf. The stars are separated by over 1000 times the distance from Earth to sun. If we will be able to reach 55 Cancri E, then we might find two stars on the sky for a particular moment. We might be able to see Cancri A with the help of our naked eye, but under the very dark night sky. But 55 Cancri B won't be visible until we are using telescope. And as I said, 55 Cancri A is a yellow dwarf, much like our own sun, because its spectral type is G8V, which is our own sun's spectral type. But the star is much cooler and less luminous than our own sun. Anyway, the star is more enriched than our sun in elements heavier than helium. It is classified as super metal rich star. The star's abundance is around 186% of our solar system. That might be indicating that the iron-rich star. Now, we will going to talk about the planet itself. The Cancri E is a tidally locked planet. That means there is a permanent day side and permanent night side. The planet's average day temperature is around 2573 Kelvin, which is equivalent to 2300 degree centigrade and 4172 degree Fahrenheit. Also, the planet's average night side temperature is around 1644 Kelvin, which is equivalent to 1371 degree centigrade and 2500 degree Fahrenheit. Initially, the scientists thought 55 Cancri E would be a smaller version of Neptune or a large rocky terrestrial planet. The scientists also came up with different kinds of assumptions about this planet. They thought it could be a water planet, hydrogen-rich planet, or carbon-rich planet. 55 Cancri E's distance from its host star is only 1.5 million miles, which is 1 by 25th distance between Mercury and the Sun. As if the planet is so near to its Sun, that's why it takes less than 18 days to revolve around its Sun. It literally means the 1 year in 55 Cancri E is equivalent to 18 days on Earth. The planet is 7.99 times as big as Earth. That is why its radius is also more than 2 times of our own Earth. There are so many things we might be knowing wrong about this planet. One thing is tidally locked. Instead, it'd be like the Mercury, rotating 3 times for every 2 orbits. As a result, it would have a day-night cycle. In this scenario, the surface would heat up, melt and even vaporize during the day, forming a very thin atmosphere that would wave could detect. In the evening, the vapor could cool and the condense to form the droplets of lava that could rain back to the surface, turning solid again as the night falls. So the lava rain is a possibility. Another one is planet might have a thick atmosphere of oxygen and nitrogen. This is where the James Webb telescope effectiveness came into light. NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory scientists will be using the Webb's near-infrared camera and mid-infrared camera to capture the thermal emission spectrum of the planet to determine the planet's atmospheric composition. Now the question is, why it called the super-Earth? The super-Earth is the synonymous to the Earth. Any planet could be the super-Earth because of its size and weight. If any planet's size and weight more than our own Earth, then it would be called super-Earth. Super-Earth does not depend on the planet's habitability. So this exoplanet hunting gives us enough knowledge about our universe and solar system. One day we might be able to crack our own explanation of existence, own code of our solar system. We will be waiting for that day. Hopefully, we might find the answers soon. Now the questions. The first question is, scientists recently discovered dwarf galaxies with massive black holes using very large array observatory. Where the observatory is located? First option is Japan, second is China, third is USA, fourth is Russia. Second question, microcom that was in the news recently is associated with which fields? First option is medicine and virology, second option is internet and communication, third is environment, fourth is nuclear science. So that is the end of the topic. If you have any questions about this topic or any other topic, you can contact me through my email address, which is tuhin.power.academy@gmail.com. If you find this topic very informative, then please subscribe my channel. Thank you very much. Thank you for your attention.